It's dangerous to go alone. Make this. Any kind of GPS readout is immensely helpful. But let's make something a bit fancy and introduce you to some Lua while we're at it. Create a new microcontroller and name it GPS coordinates. Change the width to 1 and the length to 3. Switch to the logic tab and add 3 nodes, then space them out on the schematic. Set the first node to a number input and name it GPS X. Set the second node to a number input and name it GPS Y. Change the last node to a video output and name it display. Go into the logic editor and move the number inputs to the left and the video output to the right. Place a composite right number and change the channel count to 2. Connect the GPS X node into input 1 and the GPS Y node into input 2. Open your logic gates menu and search for Lua. Place down the Lua block and connect the composite right number into the Lua script and the video output of the Lua script into the display input. Click on the Lua block and click the Edit Script button. We can delete all the text that is grayed out. These are comments and don't affect the code. First, let's deal with our first function, onTick. By default, we have these two lines, value and output. Delete the output.setNumber line and copy the value equals input.getNumber line in its place. Now we should have two getNumber lines inside our onTick function. We'll change the first line's variable name to GPSX and the second line's variable name to GPSY. The number at the end of each line is the channel to be read. Change the second line's getNumber1 to getNumber2. This gives us access to the two GPS numbers coming into the Lua block. Now to our function onDraw. I don't need the screen.drawCircle for this tutorial, so I'm going to delete this line. Screen.setColor will be used to set the color of the GPS coordinates, so you can change this to any RGB value to suit your build. I'll break the code down here slowly, but all of this is in the description for you to copy. Start typing the new code below set.color. First type screen.drawTextBox brackets. This is the container for all the text we're about to process and display. Inside the brackets, type 2, 2, w, h, string.format brackets. The two numbers are the starting position in pixels from the top left corner. The first number is how many pixels along the x-axis, and the second is how many pixels along the y-axis. W and h are the display width and height that are already set in the Lua script by default. And string.format is the function that will remove all the unnecessary decimal places. Inside the string.format brackets, type quote x semicolon percent period f backslash n y semicolon percent period f quote. Followed by comma GPSX comma GPSY. Or just copy it from the description. This jumble of characters will write out x semicolon followed by the GPSX coordinate, then drop to a new line and write out y semicolon followed by the GPSY coordinate, and remove all the decimal places off those numbers. Click the Done button in the bottom right to take us back to the microcontroller editor. Save the microcontroller as GPS coordinates and head back into the vehicle editor. Load your vehicle and open the Parts menu. Search for GPS and place a GPS sensor. Open your Parts menu again and search for Display. The 1x display and the 1x HUD are a bit too small for GPS coordinates, so I'd recommend using the 1x2 display at the very least. Place down your display and open the Parts menu again. Search for GPS coordinates to find the microcontroller we just made and place it on your vehicle. Finally, add a battery and connect all your electricity. A common issue when hooking up this type of system is not connecting electricity to the GPS sensor and not sending an on signal to the display. Connect the GPS sensor's X and Y outputs to the GPS coordinates controller inputs. Change to the video logic mode and connect the GPS coordinates video output into the display. I need to add a constant on for this tutorial to turn my display on. Spawn in your vehicle and now you have a little display that will show your current GPS coordinates and can be compared to the GPS coordinates in the bottom right of the map when in-game so you won't get lost. Thanks for watching, leave us a like, and I'll see you next time.